about to witness something like no other. The sky gon' get dark, streets gon' clutter. Weak ass niggas out there gon' suffer. Vets gon' quit, it's getting hectic. The shit got deep. Right about the time when it did skip the beat, that's when my shit hit the street. Shit gon' shake up, squads gon' break up, coats gon' get pulled, niggas gon' wake up. Everybody gon' see a chance to eat and chance the street. You know they gon' advance police. At a time that they shackle me from hands to feet, cause I gave the jail system a chance to speak.
D-Block Express, back by popular demand. Nigga comment on my video, you know what I mean? He's like, where the fuck you been at, D-Block? I'm here, man. I watch every single video, every single comment I read. So no matter what's going on in boxing, my ears are always to the fucking street, man. Everybody talking about Spence Porter, and it's getting a little lopsided. It's getting a little lopsided. So this was the best time for me to come back. Come back and make it right again, you know what I mean? Roll something. Sparks, you know, you already know my shit is rolled, nigga. Roll. Roll something. Spark something. Welcome aboard the D-Block Express. Everybody talking about Spence Porter. Porter Spence. I said Spence Porter. Were they talking about that too? They talking about Crawford versus Spence, man. Let's put it in perspective. Since I've been here for the longest, I know exactly where to go with this. I know exactly where this shit's going, okay? Now, let's take a trip down memory lane, okay? A lot of people forget. I ain't forget. You know, you got to have that type of, that 78 memory. Nobody got that type of memory. That motherfucker can remember everything, son. But you got to have some type of memory in this motherfucker. Can't just be talking out your ass. Let's talk memories, shall we? Hold on, I'm just going to take a hit of this platinum. And the reason I've been gone, there's a reason. It ain't just like, hey, you been gone. I've been gone because I'm into football. I'm into football betting now. Heavy football betting. I lost my money with my boy Yard. Shout out to Anthony Yard. Thought he was gonna get the job done. Fell short. Lost $250 on that shit. But since I've been in the betting game, I've won over $1,000. So I'm a junkie in football. Is my favorite sport. I do boxing as a, you know, let's pass the time. Love boxing, though. Don't get it twisted, man. Love boxing. I put boxing actually over basketball. Yeah, I know. What, are you crazy? You know, it's just what it is. Times have changed, you know. I fucks with boxing over basketball. That's true. I still watch everything, but if I had to pick, you know, they say game 7 of the finals is on, you know what I mean? You got to have that LeBron, Wade, and Bosh type of team for me to have to be there, you know what I mean? When it comes to, if they said, like, this finals is on, right, basketball, but then they say Joshua is fighting Wilder, what the fuck you think I'm gonna do, yo? Come on. Yeah, right. We going to watch that Wilder fight. Even if Wilder wasn't fighting Joshua, we going to watch the Wilder fight. You know what I mean? Anyway. Crawford Spence. Take a trip down memory lane with me. Crawford. And in this video, we're going to explain why Crawford is pound for pound number one. Because a lot of people don't understand why. A lot of people don't like it. They quit the throw. Your boy, Loma as pound for pound. But obviously that's been debunked since Loma has came out and said that he's not the best. Now, for real, how you going to come out and say you're not the best, dog, or another guy's better than you, and then get mad when we say that he's the best? We said he was the best before we said it. We don't need you to tell us that you're the motherfucking best. We know who the best is. How you gonna go ahead and get upset, right? When in actuality, it's us, it's the fans. We're the reason why there is a pound for pound narrative, you know? It wasn't the boxers that came out and said, I'm pound for pound. No, motherfucker. It was made for the boxer. It was made for Sugar Ray Robinson. That's what it was made for. Anyway, Crawford is pound for pound the best because of what he has done in the sport. What the fuck has he done? What has he done? Well, shut the fuck up and I'll tell you. That's why I am here and you are not. That's why I make these videos and you don't. You sit there and comment. Continue commenting. And I, I will tell you the truth. Shout out to Blue Blood Sports TV. Shout out to Blue Blood, man. Always dropping that flavor. Shout out to Fanon International Boxing. Fanon Boxing. I don't know if he changed his shit. And, of course, shout out to the boy 78, Black Fight Fan. What up? These my niggas right here, man. These my boys. You know? I ain't check on old school cats in a minute. You know, Wingy's Boxing. I don't fuck with Beats anymore. Beats can suck a dick, bitch ass nigga. I tell it to his face. It's just, you know, play possum for the longest, man. You've been a you Tekashi 6ix9ine Beats, you bitch ass. And fuck Beats, man. Thought Beats was one of us who want to see the best fight the best. You don't. You just want to come on here and complain, jump up anybody's asshole that's not USA. We know what you do, bro. 5 years you hit it on us, Beats. 5 years, homie. I stay subscribed in case you do come out your mouth on some dumb shit and I'll correct you. With facts. Not what you want to hear. You mad because motherfuckers is light years past you. You didn't want to stand strong. Didn't want to be part of the group. Mm-hmm. And we all left you behind, nigga. Oh, man. That's what you get. That's what you get. Joshua got his ass whooped right in front of your eyes, bruh. And you were like, how the fuck am I going to come on here and lie my way out of this one? And you gave up. Your man Boxing Beats and Rhymes gave up. He said, you right. You're right. We know we right. We told you that in the beginning. But you ain't want to listen. Dumbass fucking fans. You know, because your channel boosts because you could talk shit. You know, it'd be cool if you were talking the truth, not just talking shit. Actually speak the truth. Don't just speak what you want to hear. What comes out your mouth must be correct because you're saying it. Nah, motherfucker. We know if you're about that bullshit and if you're not. And, you know, it took 5 years for us to figure it out. But you about that bullshit. Anyway. Take a trip down memory lane. Fuck Boxing Beats and Rhymes, bitch ass nigga. I'm gonna fuck nigga. You lying nigga. Deal with all that, bro. Let me come out and say this. Spence is not ducking Crawford. Crawford is not ducking Spence. I might be the only one to do this video correctly because I could cut it down the middle. I have no love for either of these fighters, you know? Meaning I don't feel either of these fighters are the best of all time. So there's no reason for me to back them the way I did back the fighter who was the best of all time. I know who I'm talking about, TBE. Fuck is good. But that does leave room for me to just slice it down the middle. Not saying that when Floyd was here, I didn't slice it down the middle. Don't get it twisted now. I'm only here to find out who the best is, which is what you lame-ass fans should be here for. Not excuses upon excuses for Golovkin. Not ducking and dodging like AJ fans. You just want to see the best fight the best. If you're subscribed to me, then you already know. That's all we care about on this channel. Is he the best? Well, if he is, let's try to find somebody better. And then put them against each other. We'll see who the best is, right? Loma, the reason why you are not pound for pound number one is because you had a great fighter come up and fight you. Two weight divisions he jumped up to fight you. But then when we say Loma, go up two weight divisions and fight the best in that division, you say no. That's your problem. Don't sit here and talk like you the best and you ain't willing to do what other motherfuckers did for you. It doesn't work like that. Another reason is because there's never been a fight you have been in, Loma, where motherfuckers said you might not win this fight. You're not going to win this fight. It's never been like that. Ever. So for us to act like you're actually taking on challenges, nah, bro. You ain't. And that's why you're not pound for pound number one. You have nobody on your record that can solidify you. You can't get Regal. Two weight divisions under you, can't do that. Can't get a laid off Nicholas Walters, can't do that. He was off for about 2 years or a year or so. And then he came back and fought you. He was off for a minute. I forgot exactly the time frame. But I know that he was coming off of a long layoff and then he fought you. And who's the other dude? You get full credit for your boy, Gary Russell Jr. But he said he wanted the rematch. And you're not willing to do that. There's nothing else that you can prove. Go back and fight Gary Russell again. Gary Russell has made his stock way higher since he's fought you. Some people don't even know that you beat Gary Russell Jr. Loma. We know, obviously. But then again, there's a lot of people, even people who side with you, Black Fight Fan TV. Fuck is good, nigga. Your man Black Fight Fan sides with you. He actually says that your boy Loma would lose to Gary Russell in a rematch. And he's the biggest fan of you of all time. So what does that say, Loma? That says that you got some more work to do. Crawford has also became undisputed, undefeated. That means the best. There's no dispute of who the best is. Crawford has made that known in the 140-pound division, right? But this is where it gets fishy at, okay? And there's blame to go on both sides, and I'm gonna tell you what it is, and I'll tell you both of their flaws. See, that's the thing. When it comes to your boy TBE, say what you want about outside the ring. Inside that square circle, there is no flaw in Floyd. Mayweather has no flaws. He's literally perfect, right? But there are flaws in these guys, which is why I don't consider them the best. They are the best of their time right now. Don't get twisted. But as far as picking a side, I slice it down the middle. Both of these dudes are dead even to me. Let's talk. All right? Terrence became undisputed at 140. Moved up to 147. And the funny thing about that was Spence was there waiting with his title. He already had his title, right? Crawford approached Spence. I'll never forget this. It's on video. Go do your research. Crawford approached Spence and said, "Yo, what up? I'm here. Let's fight. What up? Let's fight." At that time, I didn't feel Crawford deserved a shot at Spence. I'm going to tell you why. You just got to the division. You have fought nobody. It's like Usyk coming to the division and fighting Wilder first. Obviously, that's not going to happen, right? Or they would already have that shit signed, sealed, and delivered. When it comes to Crawford, what makes you think you are going to carry your ass to a new division, hot division, hot, and just walk on everybody? You know, Crawford's problem is this, okay? I saw the whole panties thing, blah, 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 blah. Crawford's problem is this. Crawford's trying to take the quiet Mayweather route, okay? I'll explain what that means. That means Crawford is trying to let the quiet Mayweather, which is not real. Crawford is trying to let his skills pay the bills, right? Excuse me. But if you notice, all the best, I'm talking the best of the best fighters of all time, have all came out and stated they are the best. They don't let they let the skills talk, but they also let their mouths do the talking. You know what I mean? I asked this thing a long time ago. I said, I think it was a Crawford fucking video. It's in my videos. I'll see if I could go find it. Where I said, Crawford needs to talk some shit more. He needs to speak up more. We know you're the best, Crawford, but you have to also tell motherfuckers who don't know that you're the best, that you're the best, right? A lot of times, when it comes to the best fighting the best, we only get one side of it. And that is the fact that Crawford literally doesn't have the gift of gab. He doesn't know how to talk. He lets his skills do the talking. You know, don't get twisted now. You know, he lets his skills literally, he feels like since he's so good at the square circle, you're going to just see why I'm the best. We know this. We know this, bro. Right? But it doesn't sell to the casual. That's the problem. And even though I don't approve of anything a casual says, the casual is the one who brings in the large amount of fan base to you. We want you to be the face of boxing, Crawford. Okay? Spence, too. But Crawford, we on you. We want you to be the face of boxing. We want people to say, we watch boxing mainly because of Terrence Crawford. That's what we want to say. One, because you deserve it. You're the best, right? Pound for pound right now, Crawford, you're the best. But another reason why we want it is because it lifts the sport of boxing, right? Anything to help the sport out to make, if it's nonsense and controversy and everybody's running to it to watch it, we like that, you know? We want that. You know, we don't really want those to actually say, oh, well, we saw him throw a couple punches and he knocked this guy out, just like they did with the Wilder and Fury thing. Everybody saw Fury get knocked down, but nobody actually knew who Fury was. You know what I mean? They trying to make it a whole publicity stunt, but it's like, if you just came out and said, nigga, I'm the best, I'm going to knock this fool out, we'll be more eager to support you. You know, not only are you talking that, you walking that. You see what I mean? So we will support you wholeheartedly. But if you're not willing to come out and say you're the best, even little Oloma came out and said he was the best. Why do you have a problem saying it? It's time for bed. Go lay down. I'll be in there soon, okay? Of course, you know. Hey, it don't stop over here, man, the little ones. So, a lot of times, when it comes to the best being the best, they also say that they're the best, okay? They don't just let their skills do the talking. Even Tyson himself would have that gift of gab. And he wasn't the best. He fought a lot of B-level fighters. You know, there wasn't really a time when Tyson was pound for pound the best in the division. It wasn't. It was always someone out there that would say, I bet you he would take on Tyson. I bet you he beat Tyson, right? Because that's what happens when you're the best. They're always trying to find somebody to put against you to show why you're not the best. But you could just come out and tell them, motherfucker, I'm the best. But Crawford has yet to do that. Crawford has also yet to support those who support him. You know? Fred don't mean you no harm. Fred come out, Fred from Barbershop Conversations. Go and subscribe, y'all. Fred don't mean you no harm. How come you can't do an interview with Fred, Croft? Because it's sort of like, because a lot of people in the LDBC, we rock with your boy Spence. That's only because we don't fuck with Bob Arum. You know what I mean? But majority of us want to see the best fight the best. That's what we care about. You being over there with Top Rank is not going to let you prove that you're the best. At least over here with PBC, you have these other names over here. You can actually make a claim that you're the best and dominate in proud fashion. But on the other hand, you need to take a page out of what has already been taught. All right, you can't, Crawford, you're looking like a dumbass now. And I got my, we all this, but then we going to go over to your boy Spence. Crawford, right now, man, you shine in the shoes of your boy Bob. That's what you doing right now. This chick knocked over my fucking incense. Got the shit burning on the fucking rug, man. Boy. Light an incense, put on some lotion, man. Don't go out just smelling all crazy like that dank. Make sure you guys got the lotion and the spray. So, yeah, you know what I mean? You want to smoke a Dutch, right? And then go to a party and then have the girls come up to you like, you smell good. I had a girl, chick was sitting on her man's lap. I shit you not, on her man's lap. Just came from talking to, I think it was her cousin. I smashed her cousin a little earlier than that. But I came on the porch. Shorty's sitting on the porch. She said, there was like 6-7 people on the porch. I'm just trying to go in the house, right? She said, I don't know what you guys are talking about. And she was bad, too. I don't remember her name. She said, I don't know what you guys are talking about, but he smells good. Just stopped the whole shit. Everybody looked at me. Her man was hot. Like, he was heated, you know what I mean? Oh, God. The man was pissed off and shit. He was heated. Fucking, because it wasn't just him. It was that girl. She was sitting on her man's lap. And there was two other people who had their girl sitting on their lap. You know what I mean? And it was, all eyes were on me. And I ain't had nothing going on. So whenever y'all blaze, man, make sure y'all got that good smelling lotion. You know, make sure y'all got that good smelling spray. Put it together. You know what I mean? You'll notice when somebody comes up to you and like, yo, you smell good. And you know you just got done doing what you do. You know what I mean? Anyway, don't let me get off topic. You need to take a page out of history, Crawford. Okay? I'm going to tell you. Because maybe this video gets to you. Sometimes just the pictures that you put up will go viral and everybody click on it. What's going on? What's going on? Right? Crawford, man. Take a page out of the Bob Arum handbook, which easily shows no one is successful under Bob. You know what you remind me of, Crawford? You know what you remind me of? You remind me of that soul sister who works at the fucking, what's the shit called? It's called A&B, I forgot, or the dinner box. That's what they call it up here, the dinner box, which is a spot for just soul food, right? Now, you the manager at the place, okay? You know how to do everything on your own, but you decide to work under somebody, right? For instance, you making, let's say, $80,000 a year, which is crazy good money, right? But your boss is making $200,000 a year because you're doing the hard work for him. You see what I'm saying? Crawford, You're good enough to do this without Bob. All those other fighters do not have a promoter. Okay? The day of the promoter is over. You know what I mean? At least as far as sticking his hand in your pocket so deep that you only, when you go in, you only coming out with half of what was in there, right? Another thing is, you know that you can be successful anywhere. Any of these guys will sign you to their stable. It's not going to be just top rank to come with a bag. Crawford, you are the best. You know how much money they will pay for you on the zone? Don't you know Al Haymon will make sure that you get... Al Haymon will make sure that you get all your money, right? He might want 10% of it. That's reasonable. Besides Bob Arum taking 33% from Pacquiao. I remember that. 33%. It was equivalent to Pacquiao saying, I want a $20 million fight. And then your boy Bob said, you're not worth $20 million. One, because I'm going to get 33% of anything you make. So if you made $20 million, right, 33% of $20 million is about $13 million. You only walked out there with $13 while Bob is leaving with $7 million for just putting a fight together. Now, the problem with that is we told Pacquiao years ago, leave. As soon as you leave, the Mayweather fight will happen. This is like early 2 years into the Mayweather fight, the Mayweather-Pacquiao saga. We told this nigga, if he would just leave, be his own boss, he's so big right now, he doesn't need Bob Arum, right? And then it's not Triple G. Triple G got that bag. Trainer, get the fuck out of here. I want somebody completely different, right? But no, you would. Listen, through the history, Bob Arum lost Oscar De La Hoya. Taught him everything in the book so Oscar can go run his own multi-million dollar company, right? All off of what Bob Arum did for him, right? Same thing Bob is trying to do for Loma, but Loma doesn't speak English. So no matter how much praise you guys give Loma, no matter how much diehards know who Loma is, I cannot walk. I still can't walk into the barbershop today and ask just somebody sitting there cutting who the fuck Lomachenko is. They would not know, okay? I can't walk down any street, even when you're at a boxing event, right? I had a dude with that dude that was doing boxing. He knew Loma, but he only knew about the hype train, you know? And then he said, yo, why you hate on Loma so much? I said, because people jump up two weight classes to fight him, and he won't jump up two weight classes to fight someone else. I said, nah, man, that's not the case. And that's all they were saying and stopped. They wouldn't really go further than that, you know what I mean? But Crawford, you definitely need to get away from Bob Arum. He lost Oscar. He lost Pacquiao. He lost Mayweather. All these guys are stupid successful. Stupid. No matter how many spatulas your boy Oscar sticks up his ass and all the guests at his house, the man is stupid paid and not paying anybody else underneath him. Crawford, you're so big, man. You should have been your own production, Bud Productions, right? Your first fighter should have been Shakur Stevenson. You should have switched it around and signed Tim Bradley. That's how big you need to be, Crawford. You ain't going to get there with this, take off your panties. Watch the fans run around. You know what Bob said? And he treating you like this. Because I bet you never went to Bob and said, you know, let's fight. You even scared to talk to Pacquiao reckless. Nobody would drag Pacquiao's name through the mud. Maybe because they probably need him. But in the long run, this is a fight. I'm here to punch you in your face. I don't need to be polite to you, right? So, Crawford, why are you over there on some, hey, Pacquiao, are you willing to come get your belts back? No, how about come out and be like, yo, Pacquiao, you bitch-ass thing, I still got your fucking trophy. You scared to death to come get this. Why are you still ducking me? That's what you need to do, Crawford. And we can't keep on telling you. Maybe it's just not who you are. But as you can see, being who you are hasn't got you that far. Being who you are still doesn't command you to be a $20 million fighter every single time you go out there. Or even a $5 million fighter every time you go out there. Like your boy Spence is now. Right? Crawford, you've never even been on pay-per-view. Right? And then you hear your boy Bob come out and state. He comes out and says there's no money in the Porter fight. Now, even a casual, right? Even a fucking casual can tell you that fight should be made right now. Porter has no ties to PBC, to anybody else. There's no excuse why Bob wouldn't put him in there with Crawford, besides the fact he doesn't believe in Crawford either. He knows Crawford's a good talent, but he also knows fighting someone like Sean Porter is risky business. But he should know fighting someone like Porter will raise the stock of one of your best fighters. Not just, yeah, he's the best. You don't even consider him the best. I think there's an interview out there where Bob said Loma. Oh, no. He said Crawford is the best. Excuse me. He said Crawford is the best. He said Crawford is better than Loma. But Loma is more profitable. Loma, he could sell. Crawford, he can't sell. And you know what that means. That's because Crawford's a black dude. Loma's the white dude. Everybody wants the Great White Hope to be the best boxer. He wants somebody of another, you know what I mean? nationality to say, yeah, that white dude over there is the best fighter in the world. That's what he wants. But it's not going to happen. The closer he was getting was to Oscar, and Oscar picked up and left his ass. And he tried that shit with Pacquiao. Why do you think he's trying to do all these foreign fighters to be the best, you know? We need to sell him to the public. Tyson Fury, a foreign fighter. What's up with all the American fighters that should be the best? Like, history tells you the best of all time are Americans. You dumbass motherfuckers. So for motherfuckers to come out and just automatically, oh, no, it's England. No, stupid. You guys have Joe Calzaghe, right? And you guys have Carl Froch, who we beat. Mm-hmm. And we all know if Joe Calzaghe fought Roy in his prime, nobody ever wants to say that. I don't give a fuck. If you ain't fight Roy Jones in his prime, I don't give you full credit for the fight. No, Jack. Just like Loma, you're not willing to go up two weight divisions to fight the best. Shut up, then. And now you got all this smoke in your division. Devin Haney gonna beat that ass. Another American great. That motherfuckers don't want to recognize, right? Crawford, I heard some bad news about you too, bruh. And I'm saying all of this, and I still put Crawford, pound for pound, the best. And I didn't get into the reason why, okay? There's reasons why Crawford is the best. And it's the build-up to his fights, and then what we as fans have to go through for that fight to come to fruition. So let's say, you know, I'll give you an example. There was a lot of racist bullshit out here when Crawford was fighting Victor Postol. A lot of people were shitting on Crawford when he went to fight, what's the boy's name? When he went to fight Ricky Burns. A lot of people have Ricky Burns beating Crawford. Not only did he lose, Crawford went to his hometown and beat his ass. That should tell you automatically we got something here. Because at that time, Ricky was the one to be Ricky Burns this. And Ricky, another gray white hope that they're trying to sell. Crawford come in there, dust him right off. Fuck out of here. Next, right? Bob Arum is not willing to do anything for you, Jack. Besides get the money from you. He could still be salty about Floyd. Yeah, I ain't get that black motherfucker, but I got another one. Mm-hmm. He ain't going to be able to do shit without me. That's what Bob's saying. Mm-hmm. Bob treating you like the fans. What'd he say to the fans? You probably go to Bob. Hey, Bob, man, you know, you think you can make that fight for me? Let me know if you can make that fight. I'm trying to make it. But they don't want to make the fight with me. They don't want to call me back. In that Bob voice. Bob is treating you like he, you know, you remember that, right? The dude said, this is inside talk, okay? I'm pretty sure all of us out here have some little, you know, little knick-knack on somebody that could really exploit them. But you a general in yourself, you know. Ladies, salute with your beautiful selves. Y'all are generals in yourselves, right? So you don't just put people on blast. We don't do that. You have a sense of, you know what I mean, a sense of morality. You have a certain aura about yourself that doesn't make you stoop that low. 9 times out of 10, you don't give a fuck. You just heard some gossip. That girl cheated on that dude. Oh, shit, when he finds out. You know what I mean? Whatever have you. You know both of the crew cool like that. Tommy, Ghost, and fucking Keisha. You know what I mean? Motherfuckers, we cool like that, right? But we ain't going to just stoop down low. Like, I know some dirt on a lot of people that I know, right? But we're not just going to come out here and say it. But they did. They did it for Bob. They came out and said the dirt. Bob Arum said, for those who weren't here, you new motherfuckers. Bob Arum said, and remember I'm saying this, man, because a lot of people look at Bob and just take what he says nowadays for face value. And you got to know what type of snake we dealing with, all right? Bob Arum said this, and I'll never forget this because, first off, I didn't believe what the fuck came out of Bob's mouth anyway. Go back and do any video from your boy 78 on Bob Arum. I'm talking 2013, 2014. And listen to what them videos sound like. Yo, I mean, you know what I mean? For real. Go back to 2012. Listen to what them videos sound like about Bob. You'll see about what was happening back then. Bob was on some bullshit. I'll tell you what type of snake Bob is, okay? Snake. All right? And these are facts. We're talking facts here, right? Bob Arum said this, and I'll never forget. Bob Arum said, fans are like rocks. You heard me? A fan is like a rock. When it comes at you, you can kick it in any direction, and that's the way it will go. We have the right questions. We have what we want, you know? Like Fred, you ain't do your just do, okay? Because I'm going to tell you why. And this is the reason why they don't want me on these interviews and want me speaking to these fighters and stuff. I got to leave it in the comments section. But it's because you should have said right then and there, right? Bob has also came out one time and said black fighters don't sell. It wasn't just Sanchez that said it. Bob said this years ago, black fighters do not sell. But then you have everybody, oh, Mayweather doesn't count. Like, what the fuck? Oh, Roy Jones don't count. Muhammad Ali don't count. These fighters never sold. Shut the fuck up. Sit back and enjoy the ride. He said, literally, kick a fan. That means when you ask Bob a question, right, and he feels he's so high up on his status, his hiatus, he can literally tell you anything he wants to tell you. Well, they're not answering the phone. And you would run and believe it. Because you have nothing else to go off of, right? Besides the facts that are in front of you. Bob said this. Bob said Sean Porter and Spence didn't really do that well. That's what he said. Them niggas did 400,000 views at $75 a piece. Are you shitting me? Oh, I don't know if it'll stop the vid or not, but you know, you got that upgraded shit. Hey, Cortana. What is $75 times 400,000?
That is $30 million U.S. dollars.
$30 million! Thank you, Cortana. So, them niggas brought in $30 million! $30 million? I just did the math in front of y'all. $30 million. But that fight didn't sell. Fred should have said, hold up, Bob. That fight brought in $30 million. What are you talking about? $400,000 times $75 per whatever have you. 400,000 of them were bought. You mean to tell me $30 million isn't enough? And you over here paying your boy Crawford $3 million? Porter doesn't bring black. Those are two black fighters. They don't sell? Huh? Am I missing something here? Now, granted, I'm pretty sure they both didn't walk away with, you know, $15 million here, $15 million there. You got to pay, you know, backside. But that is a profitable fight. So, Crawford. You versus ESPN want the views, but Bob is trying to tell you to your face, Crawford, you rock. That's not going to make no money. And then you too stupid to do some math. Go do some math. You got all that money. Go do the math. They just so even if it was $350,000, right? You still talking in the upwards of $20 million plus dollars. That's a profitable fight, right? And that's the problem with Bob. You're not willing to make a Porter fight where everybody's going to get paid. Bob, you can actually make more than Alden. You could tell Porter, I'm going to give you $5 million. You could tell Crawford, I'm going to give you $7 million, $8 million. You're the champion. And then you clean up, what, $16, $17 million after that? You take home $17 million while you paying these guys, what, you know, $13 million. I mean, this should be logic, man. And for Crawford not to see this shit and think that the brothers, you know, you a black man. What Tupac said? Don't be walking down the street, you see another brother over there, say something. Say hello to that man. right? Say what up to that nigga. What's good, Wolf? You know what the fuck I'm talking about. Don't ever let no black person or sister walk past you and you not say something to them. It's hard enough out here for all them being against us. We need to stick together. We need to survive. And you do that by uplifting your people. Crawford, you ain't doing that. Crawford, you literally are acting as if we are hating. We want to see Spence fall. Nah, Spence has flaws. It's just you need to talk to the right person to know what those flaws are. You know what I mean? Crawford is still pound for pound the best. Let me reiterate. But Crawford needs to take a page out of the Mayweather, the Oscar De La Hoya, and Manny Pacquiao book. You need to get the fuck out of there, dog. And this will prove everything. You see, everybody's going to be held under a microscope soon, okay? Crawford, you're coming up to the end of your contract. So are you going to resign? Or are you going to branch out on your own? Maybe you don't feel like you can be successful on your own, you know? You might need somebody to guide you. That's fine. Why do you think all them dudes are talking to Al Haymon? You acting like he won't come and talk to you. You ain't never spoke to the man in your life, so there should be no ill will toward the man, right? Right? Unless you delusional. Mm-hmm. You know what that means? You acting like Cassidy. I didn't mean to bring him up, you know, yeah. But Cassie literally is delusional. You cannot sit here and say 5,000 people you battled and don't remember two of them that say that dude gave me a good battle or that dude was a good battle. You know, something, nothing, right? But then try to come back in this day and age and spit the same shit the same way, right? As if we just now heard you. We just now hearing about you, right? Some people can't even understand the freeway battle. Can't even understand it, right? And that nigga Freeway was giving it to you. It's just people don't understand Freeway. Some people in hip-hop, diehard hip-hop fans, don't understand Freeway. They don't understand Sheik Looch. They don't understand Ghostface. When these niggas rap, y'all motherfuckers is just clueless. I'm not clueless. I know what the fuck it is. You know, people have different styles. That's neither here nor there. What I'm saying is, Crawford, man, you literally think that your skills, us, the ones that are still holding on, that say you're the best, we're gonna get you over that hump. And obviously, if you've noticed by now, that's not the case. That's not going to happen, bro. You need to come out and put yourself over that hump. When Loma came out and said, Crawford's not the best. No, I forgot, you guys. I came out of my coma. I'm the best. Right? When he came out and said that, you should have came out and stated, word, why don't you jump up 2 weight classes to fight me then? And it came out already. Loma's team already came out and said, fighting Terrence Crawford is suicide. I even had my boy say it. You know what I mean? My boy, you know, diehard Loma fan. But he knows if he fights Crawford, that's the end of Loma, right? So keep your fucking mouth shut if you ain't really trying to be great, Loma. Talking about, I'm calling out Tank. Tank's not even in your division, fuck boy. Why are you calling him out? I understand Mikey didn't fight you. Move up and wait, bitch ass nigga. Go fight a Regis Pagreus. Regis versus Loma. I love to see it. Let me see you take that. You can't take a Linares power. You ain't taking no motherfucking Prescott power. I said Prescott. Pagreus power. Right? That's another thing Crawford did. Crawford's resume is solidified. It's stacked. People act like, no, he ain't do that. Crawford's resume is fucking stacked. Yo. Yep. Yep. Crawford's resume is no fucking joke. One, Crawford beat British Prescott. That's why he was in my mind, because he beat the dude that knocked out Amir Khan, right? Remember, Khan finally got destroyed. It was because of British Prescott, if you guys remember that. He beat him. He went up and fought Ricky Burns next. I'm talking major fights. He fought Ricky Burns. He beat, and the hype at that shit was, Ricky Burns ain't doing this, Ricky Burns ain't doing that. He beat Ricky Burns. That's a big fight. You guys have to understand, I'm not going to forget, especially when I was here, I'm not going to forget the racist and the trash talk that went along with the reason why this fight is being made. I'm not going to forget it. You guys can act stupid and forget it, but I'm not. I will never forget the build-up to Ricky Burns and them ducking and then them not fighting but still want to be the best, and Crawford's not going to win, and Crawford ain't that good, and I remember all that shit. And Crawford came out and dominated Ricky. Told Ricky, shut the fuck up, nigga. There's a new sheriff in town. Just like your boy Magic Johnson and Larry Bird said to Jordan. Yeah, you're right. There's a new sheriff in town. Saying that Jordan is the new sheriff. You know what I mean? They realized it. Let me give you another one. Gamboa. Why is Gamboa? Gamboa's huge because, one, Gamboa was undefeated at the time. Undefeated. All right? Undefeated at the time. And Gamboa was giving it to Crawford in the opening rounds. It wasn't as if, even with the height difference, because it was the weighing looked crazy, but even with the difference, it looked like, don't sleep on Gamboa. The diehards knew. We knew that it wasn't going to be just a walk in the park, and it wasn't. For the first four rounds, Gamboa, as sure as he is, was fighting tall. And that's why we hate on some of these boxers so much, like Chris Algieri, tall ass nigga that fights small than a motherfucker. And then you got someone like a Gamboa, undefeated Gamboa, that's a small ass motherfucker fighting tall than a motherfucker. So I give a lot of credit to beating Gamboa, even though a lot of people, yeah, man, that doesn't count. Shut up. That's why I do this and you don't. Okay? Another one, Crawford beat up. They want to give all this crazy, crazy praise to your boy Beltran now. They forget Crawford dusted him off. But let me talk about your boy Thomas DeLorme. Yes, the same Thomas DeLorme that should have got that win versus Jesse Vargas. But Thomas DeLorme got played. And at the time when he fought Crawford, he only lost one fight before that. So he's 20, he was, 22-1? Shout out to your boy Thomas. Thomas came out with the laser hands. Y'all don't remember this shit. You guys weren't here. Thomas came out with the, it was 2015. I thought it was 2014. Thomas came out with some lasers. I'm talking, if you could go see the Thomas DeLorme versus Crawford fight, the first two, three rounds, he's trying everything in his arsenal to show that I'm no slouch. And your man Crawford took it like a fucking boss. It was to the point where it looked like Crawford was getting pissed off and tired of your boy Thomas DeLorme still showing that he's fast, you know? It was like, I'm fast, nigga. I'm fast, nigga. Crawford's like, yeah, I know you fast. Okay, I know you fast. But I'm a fast too, nigga. I'm fast too, nigga. It looked like that. It looked like Crawford was getting so fucking mad, son, that he was like, fuck this. I'm, nigga, are you fast, DeLorme. And you fast, my G, to the point where your boy should have lost that. Jesse Vargas lost to Thomas DeLorme, in my opinion, right? They gave him a draw for it. But people still try to put Jesse Vargas up there as if he's, you know, he's like an American or Danny Garcia of the bunch, right? But they won't put Thomas DeLorme up there, right? So that's the funny thing about it. But even in that fight, DeLorme is way more seasoned than your boy Crawford was at that time. And Crawford dealt with him with ease. Crawford dealt with DeLorme as if, yeah, you fast, but not only am I faster, I'm better than you are. And there's not a lot of fighters out there to this day. I think DeLorme might have, what, only two losses, one loss. Don't make me go ahead and click on this thing. But DeLorme is definitely worthy to be recognized underneath Crawford's belt. You guys got to understand, man, all these dudes aren't household names, but that's because it's not for you casuals. It's for the diehards. We are the ones, right? You niggas don't know shit, so shut up. You don't know who Beltran is, Raymundo. You don't know who this is. Shut up. Some people don't know who Thomas DeLorme is. Shut up. You know? That's why it says on BoxRec when Crawford fought Thomas, you know how they got the red box and the green box? If you got all green across the board, that's a worthy opponent, right? Why does Thomas DeLorme have all green across the board? Because he was a worthy opponent. So you guys probably wouldn't know this. Let's keep going, okay? Hank Lundy was talking shit, but we already knew he wasn't up to the par. And that's another thing. Let me speak on the Hank Lundy shit. Okay? It could be a reason why Crawford hasn't left top rank. Yeah, I said it. So, for instance, you guys remember Crawford fighting Lundy or the weigh-in, right? When the weigh-in happened, Crawford ended up shoving your man Lundy hard as hell. Remember that shit? Super hard. And your boy Lundy literally was on some peaceful shit. He ain't mean no harm to that man. He ain't. You know, if you ever spoke to Lundy, Lundy's one of the coolest niggas to date. But for some reason, he got quote-unquote the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world rattled. You know, got him a little nervous. You know, remember when he was up there with David Benavidez? Remember that? David didn't swing. Who swung? Crawford did. You know, shoving the hell out of your man Lundy. He wasn't doing it to sell the fight. The nigga gets intimidated easily. Why you think he won't have a? He'll do it with, you know what I mean? Do it with them white folks. But won't do it with your brothers. You won't do an interview with your brothers. Like, we chasing you all over the place, but you want to sit on social media. I just don't understand. I don't understand why my trainer's not Fighter of the Year. I don't understand why I'm not Fighter of the Year. I just don't understand. No, motherfucker, and you never will understand, it looks like. Because you ain't rocking with the people that rock with you. Even though I'm on here rocking with you. I know what you went through with Ricky Burns. I know what you went through with DeLorme and Gamboa. And this next one on the list is one of the biggest reasons why Crawford is pound for pound the best. Not just dealing with what he went through. Because at that time, they were treating Crawford like they were treating Spence. Spence had to keep fighting all these dudes, Ocampo, all these dudes, right? Because they wouldn't. I think the dude, I'll never forget. I remember 78. Get my elephant memory on. The dude that was supposed to fight Crawford. Remember this shit, y'all? The dude that was supposed to fight Crawford before Victor Postol. And then they tried to throw in your boy, Sergey Lipinets, in front of this nigga so he wouldn't get the fight. There was a lot of bullshit for Crawford to just be the best, man. Right? The dude's name that he was supposed to fight, you guys probably don't know this dude. Cool movie. Crawford was supposed to fight a guy named Constantine. You guys remember that dude? Yeah, I don't know what happened to him. He probably still fighting on the low. A lot of fighters fight on the low, even though they're not the household names. A lot of these fighters. Look, right now, Ricky Burns has a fight right now. Right now. Ricky Burns has a fight. And this motherfucker hasn't been talked about in the live stream for who knows how long. Motherfucker still ain't putting out predictions on Ricky Burns. But at one point, he was better than Crawford. He's going to beat the shit out of Crawford. Crawford don't deserve a fight with Ricky Burns. I remember all that shit. I remember it. So for now, when he just destroys, right?
Oh, well, no, man. What happened was,
motherfucker. Ricky Burns has almost all green across the board. He has a light blue. I forgot what that light blue is for. But he has almost all green across the board. Right? So, it seems like there is credibility, but you guys just need to know where to give it, where to get it from, you know, how to give it. Because what I'm seeing is people who have nothing but green next to their name on here are at least a decent opponent. You can't tell me that they're not. You can't say, no, the whole box rec don't know what they talking about. It doesn't work like that, bro. It makes sense of what they try to do, which is if a fighter's fighting another fighter in a way to get points on here, you have to at least fight somebody worthy to get points. You take their points. You can't do that by fighting nobodies. Come on, man. Crawford's green across the board because Crawford is the best pound-for-pound fighter in the sport. Anyway, Victor Posto, man, they wanted Crawford to fight Constantine. And Constantine pulled out of the fight, which left a clear opening for your boy to go ahead and fight Victor Posto. And I never forget, man, there was this dude that was called, what was his bitch ass name? Pussy ass nigga. I destroyed him on YouTube. Back then, you could roast people. Nowadays, you know, you just come on here to talk shit, nigga. Sometimes that's what motherfuckers need. Niggas need a good ass whooping. His name was Men Who Take Bubble Baths, Precise Precision, Precise Boxing, Women Who Take Bubble Baths. That's how many times this man got ran off of fucking YouTube and had to come back and make a new name. That's how bad it was. He probably on here again talking that rhetoric. Talking that bullshit. And there's some people who had like a good 4,000 or 5,000 subscribers and left because they were just bullshit. They about that bullshit. But hey, you see who's still here. You know what I mean? 10 years strong, man. I do this because I do this. Fuck Victor Postal. Bitch ass nigga talking mad shit, and I loved it. I loved every minute of it. I knew it was gonna happen, right? Victor Postal was undefeated when he fought Crawford. He has green all next to his name. He's a worthy opponent, right? He also had a belt. He was a world champion at the time. He wasn't just Crawford was fighting nobody, you know what I mean? Victor Posto, from what everybody was saying, was this killer. He was this, and once again, Crawford don't deserve a Victor Posto fight. What has Crawford done? Who is Crawford be? Who, Gamboa? That's what they would say. Your boy Crawford went up there and destroyed him. All 12 rounds. I don't even think there was a round. Unanimous decision. Everybody said Crawford won. But I do remember the one round. I remember the 12th and final round. Okay? Go back and watch Victor Posto versus Crawford. It's hard to find these fights. It's hard to find Crawford versus Ricky Burns. You know why? They don't want this man to shine. It's hard to find Posto versus Ricky versus Crawford. Hard to find that fight. Go do your research. You can probably find it. Maybe on Daily Motion or whatever the fuck the other website's called. But I remember Crawford, like it was a 12th round, right? You know Crawford, stick and move type of fighter. So Victor wanted to bang. Victor was like, stop fucking, you know what I mean? Stop moving so much, you know what I mean? Just because he's too stiff. Too stiff as a robot, you know? Flat-footed than a motherfucker. Can't, you know, stick and move. Can't float like a butterfly. Sting like a bee. Victor Posto cannot do that. Bitch-ass nigga. I'm about to roll up another one real quick. Hold on. Let me get my... There we go. Yeah, they had platinum at this shit tonight, y'all. I ain't have some platinum in a minute, even though platinum's so original. Yeah, I know. But they had some platinum over there, so. Had the sour the other night. They had the Gorilla Glue out there. They had, what else they have out there? They had a couple other things out there. But there's a spot that just opened up. I want to say Connecticut or Rhode Island, where you can just walk in the store and buy whatever you want. And they got old school prices where an ounce is $4.50, you know. But you paying for some white rhino type shit, you know what I mean? That's what I'm talking about. So I might have to make a trip over there, man, just to freshen the lungs out on some bonkers shit. But I'll never forget the days of Victor Posto and what Crawford and us black fans had to go through for that fight to be made, for Crawford to once again prove why he should be the best. Let's keep it moving, man. He beat up Julius Ndongo, who was undefeated, and Jose Benavidez was also undefeated, along with Jeff Horn, and I want to say the world, not the world, but the army, literally, right? The army, literally, was backing Khan. They wanted Khan to beat Crawford. Crawford went in there to the point where your man had to lie his way out of the fight because he didn't want to be embarrassed so much, and I don't blame him. You know, you're fighting the best, man. Fuck is wrong with you? Amir Khan, you know damn well, but Khan don't care. $8 million on the table. You pay Khan $8 million. And you know you can get away by paying your boy Brook. And I didn't get to speak on that, on why, Crawford, you ain't fighting Cal Brook. You should be every single day, because I want to bet money. Every single day, you should be calling Bob Arum and ask how come that Brook fight isn't made yet. That's the problem. That's what I don't understand that. I don't understand it, right? You want to make, Crawford, if you want to make a name for yourself without fighting the names out there, you need to fight who the names have fought. Do you understand? Meaning, you can't get the Spence fight. So, beat up on Crawford. Beat up on, So, Crawford beat up on Brook, Kell Brook. Beat up on Sean Porter to show why I don't need the Spence fight. Look at what I did to his opponents and look what he did. That's what I need from you, Crawford. But I don't know if I can get that from you. Look at these greens across the board. They're saying Julius Ndongo was a worthy opponent. No, he wasn't. That was because of how Ndongo folded, right? Because of how it happened, they don't want to consider Ndongo a worthy opponent. Ndongo was undefeated. He is the unified champion. He has two belts. Green across the board, right? He's a worthy opponent. He's actually the only opponent in the way. Why wouldn't you want that fight? Right? And the funny thing is, if they brought in Sergey Lipinets, I felt like Crawford would have beat the shit out of him too. It was like, it didn't matter. I'm sitting there looking at Crawford's career, and I'm like, when he's going through these fights, and I'm sitting there like, okay, Crawford has another obstacle. Whoever this Constantine dude is, he's going to get knocked out too. And then when he gets to Victor Postol, we're going to beat the shit out of Victor Postol, right? Same thing here. Same thing with Julius Ndongo, man. The fact that there's nobody else above him. Why wouldn't you want him to just be the best? Maybe because they didn't want another black man, American, to say, we told you so, we're the best. Again, motherfucker. Right? I mean, until your boy Triple D come on the scene, until your boy Dynamite Dubois come on the scene, there's really nobody else out there that can say why Americans need to take a back seat. We run this shit, man. Motherfuckers don't run shit, man. Follow what we say and own up to it once you motherfuckers lose again because you're not listening. But I never forget in that Victor Postol fight, the 12th round, Victor Postol wanted to bang. And he said, stop running, stop running. Crawford said, okay. Oh, you really want me to stop running? Okay. And literally was walking your boy down. To the point where Postol had to start trying to float like a butterfly, stay like a bee. The whole fight, you didn't see Postol at all bopping on his back feet at all, right? The palm of his feet. You didn't see it. You didn't see it until your boy said, let's bang. Crawford, okay. You know, you called him out. Crawford's like, nigga, this is a, oh, you what? Okay. Called him out. He started beating your ass. I remember he hit you to the right, right? It was a right hook, I want to say, or a right cross, I want to say. And he hit him with a right cross, right? He hit this man, Victor Postol, so hard. The boy got hit, and, like, his head went to the left. right? But his body went to the north. It was weird, son. Go back and check it out. He literally caught the dude, and his head got turned because he got hit. But his momentum, his whole body flew to the opposite direction. It was weird, man. It's weird as hell, dog. It was just, and then Crawford was like, see, pussy, I knew you weren't on my level, you bitch ass nigga. Now you running, you know what I mean? Like, nigga, I'm boxing out here. I'm not running from you, you know, I'm boxing you. This is boxing. Just that you ain't quick enough. You suck as far as claiming that you the best. You know what I mean? Look, it says right here, the WBC title was on the line and the WBO title was on the line for the World Superweight Light title when he fought Victor Postol. So there's no reason why, you know, because they would have ran with it. They would have ran with it. They wanted Ricky Burns to be the star. No. They wanted Victor Postol to be, they wanted, remember women who take bubble baths, that bitch ass nigga, remember him? He was the one on here. Like, because nobody knew who the fuck Victor Postol was. We don't know who the fuck this dude is. He was on here just bigging him up. And Postol just, I think Postol just got knocked out recently. They were on here bigging up him so much. Not that he was that good. They just didn't want the black man to shine. Again, I mean, this shit always boils down to racism, which is why I don't understand why motherfuckers in England, like, we your brothers, man. You know? You're not my brother. And that's why your dumbass stays uninformed every single time. You stupid fucks. Because you don't want to unify. You want to stay separate. You want the likes to keep going up. You want the subscribers to keep going up about your lies. How many channels built their name off of AJ? We fucks with AJ. We were the ones that said, okay, we think you are worthy of 50 million. And then you stupid fucks back home. Oh, no, man. He's not worth, well, yeah, he's worth 50 million, but we don't want it to come from Wilder. Yeah, because our psychology will fuck you up. How you talking all this shit about you got all this money with DAZN or Matchroom Boxing and all this money over there with Eddie Hearn, but he can't pay you 50 million for a fight, but we're willing to do it, stupid fucks. Answer that for me. These are facts. Answer it. You don't have an answer. Because it's the fact. It's the fucking truth. All in all. Oh, let me talk about Crawford's flaws. Right? Hey. And it's the reason why. No, I know dude got all pissed off. I forgot where was I? I think I was online. I was talking to somebody online. And he got all upset because I said that... I have the fight a draw between, look how close your boy Porter and Spence was. It wasn't going to be Porter won the fight. It was a draw, right? So why do people act like, because I don't think either man might get knocked down in the fight. Why do people act like it can't be a draw? Draws exist for a reason, especially there for Vegas to win all type everybody's money. You bet on that guy? Well, he didn't get it. You bet on that guy? Well, give me everything. Because both of you motherfuckers didn't pick the draw. And the draw is a super big payout. Super big. It's always big. You can bet like $100 on a fighter of a favorite. And win, let's say, $30 on a favorite. That's how it is. Bet $100, you probably win about $30, maybe $20 if you're lucky, right? But for like the underdog, you know, if he comes in and wins, you bet for a draw. I think last time I saw it, it was like, if you bet on the draw, I want to say it was a Triple G fight. You bet on the draw, it was you bet $100 to win $2,500. That's what it was. Bet $100 to win over $2,000. And that's how they're rare, but if you know your boxing, you wouldn't be surprised. I wouldn't have been surprised if Spence came to a draw with Porter. You know, I knew Porter was that good. Everybody knew Porter was that good. Everybody knows Porter is an elite fighter. It just sucks it took this fight for it to realize that. But you guys will never again disrespect Showtime Sean Porter. We used to call him the mini Mike Tyson back in the day. Roll something, spark something, man. I'm sparking my shit up. I mean, I'm rolling it up now. But Duke said I wasn't here for a minute. That's why I'm here. You know what I mean? Duke said I wasn't here, so let me show love to my subscribers. For those who actually want to know about the best fighting the best. If you're subscribed to me, you realize that's what the fuck train we on. We don't care, you know? We do not care. That's why I'm so heavy into football right now. Because we don't care. Is the best fighting the best? No, I'll be back when they are. You know what I mean? Yeah, I'll watch it. But then once I'm done, I'm going back up to watch some real, real shit. A real man sport. That's what the LDBC should do. You know? Make a tradition like every... I know brothers will probably do it. Niggas always want to go out and knock niggas out. Niggas should do like every summer, right? A big event and do a celebrity football game. What up? I'll be there for that shit. I'll be on the next plane smoking. Say football, I'm there. Say baseball, you're on your own. Baseball is a game of anticipation. I can anticipate that I'm not going to be entertained. How about that? Man, you just don't know the love of baseball. I played it. Baseball sucks. Just like golf, nigga. Now, that's the thing. They're like, why do you think all these fighters go over and play golf? All these people go, you know, celebrities, black celebrities play golf. Well, one, because they good at it. You never thought that dude might be okay. He might be a decent golfer. Hey, you know. And he likes golfing. There's nothing wrong with that shit. But don't expect motherfuckers. Niggas don't shout in that shit. You can't get excited in golf. Fuck golf. You know? Motherfuckers don't even do batting right when it comes to baseball. Yeah, hey, better, sweet batter. Nobody don't do that shit no more. Motherfuckers suck. Just gotta wait for a hit. You know? Be like 7-8 innings. Ain't shit happen. Baseball sucks. And boxing sucks. Triple G, bitch ass nigga, fighting a dude you should have fought years ago. And we understand why you ducked him years ago. No, he was waiting for the Canelo fight. Well, that showed another reason why you were a bitch ass nigga. Canelo said, don't fight nobody, but I'm going to go and fight somebody. And you need to wait till I'm done. You still chasing this man to this day. Bob Arum is a snake in the grass, always will be, and he has one of my favorite fighters over there right now, man. He has Crawford locked down, B. Crawford needs to wake up. People need, like, it's to the point where, you know, Fred, Blue Blood, people who actually talk to Crawford, you guys need to just keep hammering them with it. So what? You know, when Eddie Hearn comes out the building and Fred is standing right there, Crawford need to come out the building and Fred be standing right there. Like, yo, Oscar left. Just walk with him. Don't have to say much. You know? Mayweather left. De La Hoya left. We waiting for you, Crawford. We waiting for you. And then just bounce. He might wake up. You know? Sometimes, even if you have the word to talk to Crawford, maybe you're not saying the right things. Maybe you're not asking the right questions. You're asking personal questions. Because when Bob Arum said Sean Porter and Spence didn't do so well, if you did your research, it sounded like $30 million to me. That sounds pretty well to me, right? But Bob, I guess Bob don't need $30 million. I looked up Bob Arum's net worth. Uh-huh. I'll tell you why Bob is salty. They say Bob has about $200 million. He probably has more now. I looked this up years ago. He has about $200 million. I guess you would be a little salty when you have raised pups since they were the little, you know what I mean, the little nigga. Raise them to be grown, right? And then them motherfuckers leave and go make five times what you've made, right? Haven't been in the sport as long as you have. You've been here for over 40, 50 fucking years, Bob. Where these guys come in, Mayweather, you know, 20 years in the game and quadruple what you have made in 50 years. Do you understand? So Bob might be thinking, well, nah, he ain't going to leave me. I'm gonna keep him grounded. I'm going to give him just these little trinkets to show that you need me. Without me, who's going to put up your billboard, Crawford? Oh, we can go back to your hometown where you can bring me, let's say, you know, I don't know, $1 million, right? Crawford might bring in $1 million. If Bob always puts Shakur Stevenson underneath him, Shakur's another one. Stevenson, dumbass nigga. Like, you know, if you couldn't get with Mayweather Promotions, be your own boss. Go over in there and talk to Al. Obviously, he has the answers. They aren't going to keep re-signing his contracts for PBC with multi-billion dollar companies. Billions. They're not going to redo it if it's not profitable. Obviously, them shits are selling, right? Bob is in his first year with ESPN. He ain't been doing this for years and years and years. He just did it after HBO died down and left, because that's where he used to give all his fights at. He wouldn't go to Showtime. Bob Arum has a salty rapport with Showtime. Why? Because his fucking ego gets in the way. Because Floyd went over there, and he don't want to go over there with Floyd. Right? Another reason why Bob Arum's a snake. Let me tell you this. These are facts. I remember when Bob Arum said, Floyd said, Mayweather came out, and this is the Mayweather-Pacquiao saga. This is a facts, right? Mayweather said, I can't fight in June, right? Or, it was Pacquiao was supposed to be fighting in May. And Floyd said, I ain't got no fighter in May. I still have it saved on my phone. He said, I have no fighter. Let's give the fans what they want. Floyd was actually considering Pacquiao being a boss. And just, it didn't realize why the fight wasn't getting made. And it came to fruition that Pacquiao wasn't his own boss. Everybody wanted to put him on a Floyd type of boss level. Floyd's like, yeah, I'm making, you know, well, Pacquiao, he's like that 0 to 10 million. I'm at that 10 to 90 million range. There's a big difference. There's levels to this shit. But it's true. You know, Floyd literally had to realize, oh, well, I'm a boss, so I should be talking to the boss. The one who's in charge is Bob Arum. It's not Pacquiao. And he said, I could fight for May, right? Pacquiao said, I'll fight you in May. Floyd said, all right, you know, let's get it in. And then the rumor came out, the shit hit the storm and said that Floyd wasn't going to go to jail. Floyd was supposed to go to jail in May. That's what it was. Mayweather was supposed to go to jail. Pacquiao was running around town talking about, I will fight him. I'll fight him, but he's going to jail. He's lucky he's going to jail. I'll beat his ass. That's what it was at one point. The judge came down and said, Mayweather, you bring over $1 billion. I don't think people know how much they know how to say it. They know how to spell it. They don't know how much $1 billion is, okay? If hundreds of millions can change generational wealth, you know, your children's 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 don't ever have to work, right? Then what do you think a fucking $1 billion will do? They said, Floyd Mayweather, you bring in $1 billion to the city of Vegas when you fight. So you know what? We're going to hold off on this jail sentence for one more month. We're going to let you fight Pacquiao in May to generate that type of revenue for that city, and then you can do your jail sentence. The news hit the fan. Everybody went crazy. Oh, shit. Fight's getting made now. Floyd ain't got to go to jail. He can fight now. He can fight now. Let's go. Floyd didn't have to go to jail until June 1st. I'll never forget this shit. June 1st, Floyd had to ship off. He was going upstate, right? But your boy Pacquiao came out and said, Floyd came out and said it immediately. I don't have to go to jail. The judge said I don't have to go to jail. I don't have to go to jail till June. We can now fight, Pacquiao. Let's make it happen. Right? Pacquiao came out with some of the absurdness I've ever seen. Or Bob Arum did. They started doing negotiations. This is how bullshit it was, right? Bob Arum said, Floyd, for every pound, this is the, remember in negotiations, even when you're going against your arch nemesis, somebody's going to want something. Unless you are Mayweather status, you know, money Mayweather status, you don't get to pick and choose, you know what I mean, what you want, you know? If you're fighting, if you get a chance to fight Floyd, he'll say, I'm going to give you $500,000 and you're going to be happy just to be able to fight him. You see what I'm saying? It wasn't like that. When Floyd had a chance to really fight Pacquiao, them motherfuckers came out and said, for every pound, this is considered ducking. For every pound you come in over Floyd, this is the great Bob Arum, everybody. Every pound you come in over Floyd, we want $10 million. Are you shitting me? Are you shitting me? You want how much? Hold on. Let me spark this real quick. Because I couldn't even believe I had to say that shit again. Bob Arum told Floyd, first off, some fighters will never see $10 million in their whole career. Some fighters will never see $1 million. There's a lot of fighters who get paid $77,000 in one night and then lose it all on the same night. I forgot. Dumbass nigga. Forgot what fighter that was. Yeah, $77,000 in cash. Put it in his suitcase. When he got back, that shit was gone. Whole fight money gone. I forgot who it was. But, you know, it's the fact that it was clear reasoning why the fight should be made. And you still trying to come up with all this bullshit and rhetoric to say, well, we offered Floyd a fight, but he ducked out of it. He wouldn't take our $10 million for every pound he came over. I thought he was the money man. That's what they wanted to do. And they wanted to do that. But what did your boy Floyd do? Floyd accepted the terms. Floyd said, that's a deal. That's what you want in this negotiation table. Since you are a name, since you are bringing something to the table, you're going to want something. That's what you want? Okay, I agree to it. If I come in any pound over, which is fucking absurd, I will give you $10 million. Absurd shit. Right? But then if Bob actually did his research, you have Floyd on your team, stupid. If Bob actually did his research, Bob would know Floyd has never came in fucked up when it comes to making weight. Never came in overweight, ever. All of a sudden, the man stays in shape year round, always ready to bang, always. So it's not that long to get right back in shape, fighting shape, you know. Year round, Floyd stays in shape. So in the biggest fight of the century, you're telling me he's not going to stay in shape? I don't know. See what I mean? Sometimes it's bullshit. And that was a clear sign that showed Bob Arum, you're a fucking snake. And at that time, we were also saying, Pacquiao, you need to get away from Bob. He's stealing way too much money from you. And then we all did the research, and he ended up saying, Well, Pacquiao's still under contract. Bob Arum always comes out and puts his foot in his mouth. He said, Pacquiao's under contract. He still owes me 33% from everything that he does. I'll never forget it. 33%. Damn, Bob. You already got $200 million. You already got $300 million in the bank. But you mean to tell me you need some more? You need all these other hundreds of millions? Something wrong with that. It goes to show me that you don't know when you have the best underneath you and what to do with them. You're too busy still trying to be that rich ass, salty ass fucking Jew that people love to despise because you have money, thinking you know it all. And people slap the shit out you, Bob. Turn you into Bashir. I shit you not. I'm just be glad I'm not at the, I'm not, that's what I'm saying, man. I'm not the type to hold my tongue, you know? I'll tell you what the fuck it is. And if you don't like it, suck a dick. Straight up. If you don't like it, that's too fucking bad. It's just, you just mad because you don't have the heart like I do. Like some of these great fighters do, where Floyd will come out and tell you he's the best. Or Ali will come out and say, I'm the best. He's not the best. And then tell you why. He's too ugly to be the champ. But back to your boy Crawford. I was just trying to put you guys on a little insight of a history of how Bob Arum gets down. He's a snake, man. He's a weasel, man, you know? He loves his fights in-house. That's another thing about Bob. If Bob can always use his own fighters to fight each other, he's thinking in his mind, all of the overdraft, all the extra money comes to me. I don't have to share it with nobody. What Bob isn't realizing is you don't have two greats. If he was smart, if Bob was so smart and he wanted to be the promoter, the face, you go to Top Rank to find your news, all that shit, he would put Loma in there with Crawford and just let the best man win. That's what he would do, right? Because you best believe if he did that, you might get $1 million, a million people to buy that shit. You see what I'm saying? You put it on publicity, right? Why do you think Fury and Wilder did so well? Because they had the shit broadcast on Fox, CBS, the correct places. Where people are sitting down doing absolutely shit, and it comes across your TV screen. Not on ESPN. You go to ESPN to watch either the top 10, super late to see all the highlights. You know what I mean? I forgot Pardon the Interruption was even on ESPN. I saw it when I was at the casino the other night. I'm walking past, I see the shit up there. I'm like, oh, yeah. You know, Around the Horn, I forgot all them shits came on. Right? Motherfuckers is busy in the evening. Niggas ain't sitting down at 5 o'clock in front of the fucking TV. Get the fuck out of here. That was the olden days, man. You can get it on your phone. You ain't got to be in front of ESPN no more to get all the news about what's going on with ESPN. And Crawford needs to realize that. Crawford needs to realize, yeah, we call you the best, but you need to come out and say it. Not sugarcoat shit. Not be quiet about shit. Don't come out here and say, you know what I mean? Pacquiao, you going to come back and get your belts? How about, nigga, you'll never get these shits back. You can dream about getting these shits back, motherfucker, you little midget. Talk that shit, you know? Not just when motherfuckers talking to you. That still shows the immaturity in you, Crawford. Where David Benavidez can talk shit from you ready to jump in the ring. You taking swings at press conferences where you could have, if you connected with Jose Benavidez, if one, he could have sued you, two, the fight would have been off. You would have fucked it all up, all because of your emotions not being in check. That shows a sign of professionalism, you know? Huge sign of professionalism. You wouldn't be able to talk shit to Kell Brook face to face. You probably end up taking a swing, Crawford. And that could be a reason why motherfuckers lean to Spence. Spence is more disciplined than Crawford is. You could tell by the fucking, you could tell by the fights. You could tell by the weigh-ins. You could tell by who gets pissed off the easiest. We're trying to have a conversation with you, Crawford. We're trying to, you know, we're trying to let you know, because this is the thing. We're trying to let you know that you're working with a snake. This is the thing. Let's say this. If I buy a car, right? And people, friends, family, who have had the car before me, keep telling me that car is going to shit on you one day. that car's going to be a piece of shit. I went through this, 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 and this with that car that you just bought. Do you think I'm trying to listen to what they say after I just put my whole, my hard-earned money? You know, I can't get the car back. Crawford can't undo the contract that he signed with Bob. So when we say Bob is snaking you, Bob is a cheat, it sort of could come back to Crawford to say, well, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I don't know what I'm picking or who I'm picking. So he automatically goes on the defense to say, no, motherfucker, you guys, you black pieces of shit, don't know what the fuck you're talking about. That's what he's doing. And run over to TMZ, who don't know shit about this boxing game. You know? Because if diehards talk to us, eventually he'll end up coming around to the real shit. Crawford will end up speaking to one of us and we'll say, man, I'll never forget that Gamboa fight when he was fighting tall and we gave him the first four rounds. I'll never forget how Thomas DeNorme came out with them lasers. I'll never forget you beating up the undefeated Jeff Horn, the same Jeff Horn that gave Pacquiao everything and beat the shit out of Pacquiao. And it also shows why Pacquiao don't want to face you. Look what happened to Jeff Horn. Right? There's a lot to this. Crawford has a phenomenal record. But if motherfuckers ain't willing to bring it up to him, you know, or if he ain't really willing to listen, right? If everybody spends, well, Spence is the talk of the town. He's selling. He's also saying. He said it multiple times. I'm the best. These guys don't want to fight me. I'm the best. These guys don't want to fight me. This is before you, Crawford. Before you. You know, no disrespect to Crawford coming in here and like, man, I want to fight him. I know you want to fight him. But what I'm saying is, before you came on the scene, Crawford, Spence has always been calling out these guys. You know, he's been already up here trying to hold counsel. And motherfuckers is ducking and dodging for days. Like, I'm going to keep that for the Spence video. I just want to give some take on why Crawford is pound for pound the best. You see what it is. Undefeated Posto. Undefeated Gamboa. Undefeated Ndongo. Undefeated Jeff Horn. Undefeated Jose Benavidez. And all these guys are credible wins. And nobody wants to give props for it. So until your boy Loma has a resume stacked like this, or has somebody on his resume that we say, dog, you ain't gonna win that fight, then you can start seeing him overcome adversity. We haven't seen that from Loma. What, he got knocked down and he got back up? Well, if you're the best of all time, stupid, if you're the best pound for pound Loma fans, you shouldn't be getting knocked down in the first place. Floyd never got knocked down and still jump up. I'm the best. No, motherfucker. Obviously, you're not, right? The best should show that nobody is on their level. Sort of what Crawford and Spence are doing. Loma, you don't show that. You coming out with your face all fucked up. You getting knocked down in fights, right? I mean, there's no reason why, and you only got a little bit of fights, and you lost already. Why are people still forgetting that you lost, right? To the point where Crawford is undefeated. He fought all these dudes. Listen to these shits, man. Gamboa was 23-0. 23 fights is already under his belt. Posto, 28-0. Ndongo, 22-0. Jeff Horn was 18-0, but he just came off of that fresh ass whooping to your boy Pacquiao. Jose Benavidez, 27-0. So when your man Loma starts fighting dudes with these type of records, then we can start talking about being the best. Until then, I don't want to hear that shit no more. Crawford is pound for pound the best. And if motherfuckers don't want to crown him, you need to go on your boy's resumes and really tell me why. I just went down his resume on the legit fights and why he's pound for pound the best. The shit that we had to go through, not just, it's racist talk, that's cool, But just thinking that Posto is better, a better fighter than Crawford. No, motherfucker, you don't know boxing. Half of you motherfuckers don't know shit about boxing. Right? Your man wasn't lying when he said that. And I agree. Shout outs to Roger Mayweather, man. Hope his health and condition isn't that bad, man. But I heard that it's just getting worse and worse. But shout outs to the Mayweather family. All that fucking money, Floyd. You better go find somebody to keep this man up and moving. But, yeah, man. So, yes, Crawford does have a resume. Crawford does have the talk to be considered pound for pound the best. Yes, you are pound for pound the best. You're the only one doing it to be undisputed. That means nobody can fuck with you in that division and then move up, win the world title, and then you want the heavyweights in that division. Because Crawford has never changed his tune. He's never came out and said, well, that fight doesn't make sense. Or, I'm going to get to it when I get to it. Anytime he's asked about Crawford or Spence, Crawford always comes out and says, yes, I want the fight right now. I want the fight. He ain't as good as people think. You know? And Deuce said, if I had to lean to a side, yeah, I'd probably lean to Crawford's side. You know, Spence will have to get on the inside. He cannot box with Crawford. It's not happening. Crawford would outbox Spence all day long. That jab in his face all day long. Spence will have to eat some glove to get on the inside. But I'm going to tell you like this. If he gets on that inside, you might want to put your money down for a draw. No lie, when it comes to that fight, I might bet on the draw. I think it could be a draw, man. Crawford has flaws, and flaws, which is crazy. Crawford's flaws is exactly what Spence exploits, okay? Crawford's flaw, because a lot of people want to know, you know, you say your favorite fighter. You know, my favorite fighter of all time is Floyd. You cannot find a flaw in Floyd. That's why I consider him the best. I can find a flaw in your fighter, no matter who it is. Canelo, stamina, juicing. Don't get me started. You know what I mean? Loma, getting knocked down, losing. Don't get me started. There's a flaw in all you motherfuckers. Not Floyd. But what I'm saying is, Crawford, your flaw is you don't like to fight on the inside. You and the inside don't get along that well. Never have. You just don't like to fight on the inside. Not saying you can't do it, right? Not saying you can't bang with the best of them. You just rather fight on the outside. And I'm going to tell you like this. Crawford is so gifted. This is how good Crawford is. I know the best about Crawford, you know? I know why Crawford is the pound-for-pound best. Crawford is so gifted that he could take a world title fight like a Victor Posto that you guys want to claim is the best. He could take that type of fight and come out in a southpaw stance. A lot of people don't like that shit. I don't like it. Because when I knew Crawford, when he fought Gamboa, he didn't come out joking. When he fought Ricky Burns, he ain't come out joking. Fighting in a southpaw stance when you know damn well that you a fucking righty. We all know this, Crawford. We know that your normal stance, your most successful stance is the orthodox position. So that shows how great you are. I know how great you are, Crawford. That shows that you are willing to come out, fight a completely different style, and still make it look easy. Sometimes it's so easy it becomes boring. Right? What fight was it? I want to say the one that exploited. People would say he got exposed. And then they'll never say how he got exposed. He got exposed. Crawford did get exposed about the fact that he doesn't like fighting on the inside, or maybe is not that good at fighting on the inside. And that happened in the Felix Diaz fight. I went to that fight. Shout out to Felix Diaz. As of right now, he has a fight coming up. Shout out to Diaz. Seal, signed, and delivered. Ready to bag. See? And he's a two-time, he's a gold medalist. Gold medalist. That's another thing. And he made him look like a sucker. Diaz only lost one fight at that time also. So he was a worthy opponent for your boy. And I remember that fight. Felix got so mad that he just bum-rushed your boy Crawford. Felix Diaz bum-rushed Crawford, hitting him with anything. You know, really Sean Porter that nigga. You know what I mean? He giving him the Sean Porter treatment, right? And I remember he threw two downstairs and came with the left hook upstairs, and he caught your man. He caught your man Crawford, yo. My boy Crawford got caught. And he was hurt. He was hurt, right? Crawford got hit so hard, and this one you know someone's hurt. Crawford got hit so hard, he went to smiling. It wasn't that smile, because Floyd would get hit hard. Floyd wasn't smiling, because that shit hurt, right? Floyd would smile at the ones that are a joke, correct? So, when Floyd got hit hard, he would not laugh about it. He realized he got hit hard and had to go back to fundamentals. Wrap up, you know, take my time, you know what I mean? Back up a little bit, give him some distance. Crawford got hit hard, and he started smiling. I've seen a lot of fighters get hit, and it was a smile of embarrassment, you know? I'm here trying to promote I'm the best, but this motherfucker just blasted me. So I'm going to laugh it off to make it look like that shit ain't hurt, but I'm hurt like a motherfucker right now. You know what I mean? I'm trying to think of another fight where the dude was smiling, but he was getting beat up. I'm trying to think of it. What fight was it? Damn, I can't even think of a fight, but I can think of people's faces. Who was it? There's plenty of people. Joshua. Thank you, Joshua. You mean to tell me Joshua was having a good time when he was getting off of the canvas? Or was he hurt trying to laugh it off to show, I'm not that hurt, you guys? That's what I mean. I knew there was something that recently happened when Anthony Joshua got knocked down or beat up and punched in the face and then dropped. He was on the canvas laughing, smiling, because he was like, man, you know, this little motherfucker just put a number on me. He probably let the whole world know I'm not the best right now. So I'm going to laugh it off to make it show like, yeah, motherfucker, I'm good. I'm fine. Right? You saw how that went. You saw what happened there. So don't be surprised when someone gets blasted and then they start laughing. That motherfucker's hurt. And the thing that hurt Spence was not the left hook upstairs. It was the body shot. Or I said Spence. The thing that hurt Crawford in the Felix Diaz fight was the body shot. It was that body. He caught him upstairs because Crawford was trying to block downstairs. But Diaz was already done downstairs and came upstairs with it. And when he did that, I could see right then and there, Crawford does not like the inside. Think of all the times when he's close just in a weigh-in. Doesn't like being close to motherfuckers, right? Because if you good at body shots, right, and you close, like face-to-face with somebody, you know damn well if I just punch this nigga right here in his fucking liver, this motherfucker's going down. And he won't even know it's coming because he won't be tightened up at the time, right? So being this close really doesn't bother you. I know how to defend against body shots. I'm pretty good. But when it comes to your boy Crawford, it showed in that Felix Diaz fight. And diehards can always refer back to that fight. That is the fight that showed when everybody says Crawford got exposed, that's the fight that it happened in. But people don't say that. People don't come out and say Felix Diaz is the one who exposed Crawford. Crawford does not like to fight on the inside. The reason why people can pick Spence, or I could see Spence winning, Spence is probably the best inside fighter on the planet. Who throws better body shots, harder body shots, more accurate body shots than Spence? Nobody. Spence is the best when it comes to the body. Just like Gary Russell has the fastest hands in boxing, Spence is the best when it comes to the body. So I could see Spence getting on the inside, getting to that body, and maybe systematically breaking down my boy Crawford. You know what I mean? Now, I could keep going, okay? But that's the thing. Crawford doesn't like to find the inside. That's his flaw, even though he does things so great, which is he can come out and fight not even his style and win by landslides. That's another thing. Crawford, if you're going to be Spence, you got to fight orthodox. You cannot fight southpaw. He is a southpaw. He is a better southpaw than you are, Crawford, because that's what he does. You've never seen Spence come out and try to fight orthodox. You notice that? Never seen it. You have seen your man Crawford come out and show off. Like, I can, it's my circle. I do what I want in there, which is true. But you're probably not going to be able to do what you want to someone who does what they do. Right? I come in, I shoot 3 jump shots in a row. You mean to tell me I'm a better shooter than Reggie Miller? Because I just shot 3 in a row and he walk in the gym. Who you putting your money on? He ain't shoot at all yet. Who you putting your money on? Reggie. And you see what I'm saying? Even though you already know I did do 3 in a row. Right? So, as far as Diaz is concerned, Diaz is probably the only one on this planet to expose, quote unquote, Crawford, and to show why Spence could be better than Crawford. I don't put him there yet. Even with the Spence-Porter fight, that fight just proved that we knew Porter was that good. It wasn't Spence wasn't going to win. We knew Spence was going to win. We knew Spence is a better fighter than Porter. But we also knew it's going to be hell. Bring your lunch, bro. It's not going to be an easy fight. It's not going to be. We knew this. Diehards knew this. I had the prediction up here. If you want me to upload it, just say it. I will upload the prediction that I made for that fight. It was like a 51-minute video. I still have it up here. And the only reason why I didn't upload it is because it, like, the microphone was fucked up. It had, like, a lot of background noise. It picked up. So I'm sitting here just trying to chill, and that shit is picking up all my breathing and shit. Like, it was, I had to, this thing that says gain on it, I had to mess with that a little bit so that, you know, it didn't sound fucked up. But, let me see here. Yeah, I turned the game, see? So, you know, that's Crawford in a nutshell. That's why Crawford is pound for pound the best, because of what he went through to get to where he's at. Also being undisputed and being undefeated. That makes a big difference, man. If Crawford was not undisputed at 140 and just moved up to 147, he probably wouldn't be considered the best pound for pound fighter. But the fact that you are, and the fact that no matter if you did go back down to that division or not, you would smoke everybody down there. And it's reason to believe you could smoke everybody where you're at. So, the flaw, not only to the body, but the other flaw is just pure selfishness. Crawford, you can't be selfish, dog. We're only here to help you. You know what I mean? We want you to succeed. We want the black man to succeed, okay? They want the Mexican brother to succeed. They want the Puerto Rican to succeed. You don't think we want the brother to succeed? 2 black men to pull in $60 million in one night? Get your fucking money, fellas. You know what I mean? For you Spence fans, I sometimes question you, right? Because you can't sit here and tell me all about Spence and not know about Crawford. Crawford was already doing it way before Spence came on the scene, right? You don't hear Spence down at 140. Crawford was already knocking down buildings before Spence came on the scene. So that's why it's kind of hard to take people serious. You know, that's why you listen to people like me who can call it right down the middle. You can't take people serious when they like, yeah, Spence is going to destroy him. You obviously don't know boxing. And more or less, you don't know Crawford. You don't know Spence. I'm a bigger fan of your favorite fighter more than you are. Same thing with this football shit. Right now, because I do fantasy, if you do fantasy football, I'm telling you, if you're a football fan, do some fantasy football. Because fantasy football makes you a fan of the entire NFL. Not just one team. My favorite team is the 49ers. Shout out to my man Eagles Boxing, because he's a 49er fan too. Us Niners got to stick together. Shout outs to my boss. I can't stand the bitch. She cool as hell. Still can't stand her. She my boss. But she's a Niner fan, so shout out to her. But being a fan, like a fantasy, I'm a fan of all teams. And I'm saying this because if you're going to be a fan of a fighter and he has a potential fight with someone else, you should probably do your research first before you just jump on the same bandwagon as your favorite fighter. Okay? All you guys who actually thought Porter, now people are coming out to woodwork. Porter won. Porter could have won. How is Porter going to win when Porter got knocked down? Right? What's wrong with you? If it was a dead even match and Porter got knocked down, how is it an even match? It's not. Spence won. It was the right man who won the right job. And even in the rematch, I think maybe Spence might do even better. You know, he already knows how you fight. You know, as good as you are, Porter, you were getting caught sometimes in that fight. There was times in that fight you were getting caught. And majority of the fight, you stayed on the back foot. I remember that Spence probably wins again if you guys were to fight. And what I didn't get to talk about, which is if Porter were to fight Crawford next, I would probably pick Crawford to beat Porter. But it's not that. It's the argument that Bob isn't even willing to make that fight. And Porter is doing what we did with AJ, which is, we're giving you too much credit, bro. Yes, pound for pound, you're the best, but you are clearly not your own boss. As much as you want to get rattled and get upset when we say that, you are clearly not in charge of your career, Crawford. And it shows by you just, this is going to be it. If you re-sign your contract, which is at the end of 2019, if you re-sign your contract, and you're going to stay with Top Rank for another 3 years? Yeah, man, I might have to say maybe you're not informed, or, and I don't want to do it, maybe you're ducking, you know? You know you don't have to fight. You know that you can leave, go and fight Spence, beat him, come back to Top Rank after the fight's over. You know that he'll take you back, right? If you really want to do that. But I can't always knock you on it, because you did what you were supposed to do. You know? Die hard. Spence fans. And I'm going to say it in the Spence video when I make it. I might not make it tonight, but I'm going to make it. Spence fans. Your boy says Spence came out and told Crawford when Crawford first got to the division. Spence said, go fight Jeff Horn. Go fight Jeff Horn and go get that belt. I'll fight you if you get a belt. If you become a champion, I'll fight you. Crawford said, bet. Right? There was no more. I remember when it happened, because it died down after that. We just knew that these guys are on a crash collision course heading straight for each other. You know what I mean? We knew it. But it was the fact that Crawford had some work to do, right? Crawford needed to somehow, some way, become a world champion. And he did. He went and got the belt. And I understand sometimes when Crawford's a little pissed, like, yo, I went and got the belt. You claim you a boss. Let's make the fight happen. You know? But at this time, by the time you went and got the belt, Spence's also got some shit lined up. I got fights. Plenty of them. You see how many fights this man Al Heyman has? And who you over there fighting? The Dream Machine, somebody. Kawanaka Black or Black. I don't know the man's name. Ski. So he's a ski at the end. He look like a little ski. These motherfuckers. But you fighting no names, bro. And it's tearing up your career. It's tearing up being a fan of you, man. Especially how you treating people who actually do care about your career, you know? And another thing, man, don't be so hyped to meet up with these celebrities, all right? I'll tell you a story. It's going to be it, and then I'm up out of here. I stayed at this hotel. I worked at this hotel one time, right? And when I worked at the hotel, the wrestling, WWE, was coming to the hotel at the time to stay there, and then they were going down to, like, the Pepsi Arena to put on their show, right? WWF, okay? WWE, whatever it is called now. And this wasn't that long ago. I want to say maybe 2013, I want to say. They came and stayed at, I'll never forget, because that tall Indian dude, I think he passed away. I hope not. But that tall Indian dude, I don't know wrestling like that. We had to get two beds for the nigga. Tall ass nigga. Had to get two beds for him. And I'll never forget, the boy's name is Mark Henry, okay? Now, the whole build-up, this is the whole thing about talking to celebrities, okay? The whole build-up to them coming to the hotel, I was hype. I was excited because Booker T came to the hotel, too. And it was crazy because I was on the elevator with the man, and I didn't even know it. He walked. I've been a fan of Booker T since back in WWC days, back when Goldberg was running shit, back when NWO was running around, back when Sting was running around with the all black and white on. Y'all probably don't remember that. But I was on the same elevator with Booker T. And if anybody was coming, I would have probably wanted to talk to him the most, you know. But this is what happened, right? Mark Henry, who is considered one of the heaviest athletes of all time. I think he weighs on some 450 type shit. But he's a big ass fucking dude, son. Black dude, big ass dude. Because there was a big thing back in the day where if you could body slam this guy, you would get crazy points in the wrestling day, you know? Before I found out wrestling was fake. If you could body slam Mark Henry, and the dude that was body slamming everybody was Lex Luger. Lex Luger would body slam everybody. It ain't matter how strong you were. He would pick your ass up and slam your shit. But Mark Henry came to the hotel, and I was a fan. I was a huge fan of Mark, right? Now, this is a big-ass dude. I'm talking, if he wanted to, he can probably grab a nigga. You know what I mean? I ain't no small dude. He probably grab me and just throw me over the fucking counter. You know what I mean? With ease, right? Go type in Mark Henry and you'll see who the fuck I'm talking about. So he came down to the desk, and I out of all the wrestlers coming, I was a fan of Henry coming. Because I didn't know Booker T was coming, or I would have been really looking out for Booker T more than anybody. But Mark Henry was coming, so I knew him and I was cool. I was like, yeah, Mark Henry, Henry's coming. So he came down to the fucking desk, and there's like this little gift shop next to the front desk, right? He goes in and gets his stuff. Now, I forgot what it was, but I think I spoke to him before he came down to the desk. I think he might have called the front desk. And he said, I'm going to pay cash for my stuff, okay? Because he didn't want to put it on the room. He didn't want, I guess sometimes celebrities don't want people knowing where they are, especially in a hotel room, you know? I said, cool, it ain't a big deal. You can pay cash, whatever, right? He come down to the desk. Normally, okay, now think of this. Normal routines. Let's say it's not Mark Henry. It's just a normal guest that comes down. The first thing we would say, do you want to put that on your room? You want me to add it? Because it's simple. You know, you don't have to pull out cash. You don't have to pull out a card. Nothing. Put that on room, whatever, whatever, whatever. You know what I mean? So we just ask them ahead of time. When you get something out of the little store that they had, once they come to the desk, you just ask them, yo, do you want to put that in your room? Yeah, just throw it on room 165. Okay, boom. He walks away from the desk. Gone. We tally up what he had in his hand, and he's out. So when Mark Henry came to the test, I said that shit to him, forgetting or being absent-minded that I spoke to him earlier and he wants to pay cash, right? So this big-ass nigga got hostile. Word bond. Now, I don't care who you are, you know what I mean? It don't matter who you are, right? Nigga, you ain't gonna talk to me no way. This nigga said, he said, let me be clear. He said, yo, ain't I talked to you earlier? I already told you I want to pay cash for this. And me being professional, you know, he said it in like an attitude form. I'm a professional at all times unless it causes me not to. And I should have wild out right there because, you know, you hit me, I'm suing everything. Oh, I hurt my back, my neck. Everything hurt, nigga. This big ass nigga just paralyzed me. He probably could have did it. The nigga looked like if you stand four people at the front desk of a hotel and he just took his hand and then just, you know what I mean, came across, he could probably knock all four people down with one swing. That's how big this motherfucker is. Mark Henry. He was a world champion at one time in boxing. And I said boxing. In wrestling. You know, wrestling's fake and shit. But I think he was a world champion at one time. But regardless, go type him in. Go type in Mark Henry. You'll see who the fuck. Big ass face. Big ass nigga. And I never forget, man. I was... You don't want to feel like that, okay? I felt like, you know what? Fuck you, nigga. You know what I mean? I made a mistake. You see what I'm saying? You acting like people don't make mistakes, or we're not allowed to make mistakes, or you're so popular, I want to know what... I know what room you're in. I know what room all you motherfuckers are in. I'm the one that put you in there, stupid fuck. But you are salty. Because I said, yo, you want to put that on your room? Nah, didn't I tell you I want to put it on my room? I want to do cash. Oh, yeah, I apologize, Mr. Henry. We can do cash for you, you know? Kept it professional because, you know, I did mess up. But it was just a habit. It's, you know, just a habit that I had. But it makes you like, if you, let's say you were one of the biggest fans of Mark Henry and you went through that situation, you're not too eager to meet another big celebrity that you might think is one of the coolest people around, you know? Henry looked like a brother. Looked like a nigga that I could just, you know what I mean? That's my mans right there. That nigga, you know what I mean? You can kick it with that nigga. But, yeah, that changed everything. It shows why, you know what I mean? That changed everything. So why you an ugly ass motherfucker. Probably don't get shit. But, it just, you know, and it sucks because, like I said, I was very excited that he was coming to this particular hotel. That he was coming to, you know, I could meet this man in person, you know, and just wanted to congratulate him on some of the highlights that I have seen. I didn't think that dude could pick you up. You know what I mean? I didn't think that, you know what I mean, your big ass body could fucking, I mean, leg drop on people. That's not fair. You know what I mean? Have a good chuckle with the nigga. You know what I mean? And it just went completely the wrong way, man. And just to this day, like, fuck Mark Henry. You know what I mean? Like, dog, it wasn't supposed to be like that. You know what I mean? It wasn't supposed to be. We weren't supposed to. That happened to me a couple times where I don't know why people get salty. I mean, I understand that Mark Henry shit and, you know, you're trying to stay discreet and da 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 da. If that was the case, motherfucker, you should have ordered this shit up to your room. You ain't have to bring your fucking big ass down here. You should have ordered this shit to your room and then you really could have stayed discreet where motherfuckers did not care who the fuck you were. Nobody came up and ran for you to sign an autograph. They were doing that to other people. They weren't doing that to you. But it all goes back to, you might not want to meet your celebrities. If Crawford don't want to listen, then we ain't going to continue to talk to him. You know what I mean? Let him live a lie. Let him find out the hard way. Let him not follow the Oscar, not follow the Mayweather, not follow the Manny Pacquiao blueprint that Bob Arum has set for us. As you can see, the little one is up because I'm out here doing this D-block. And I'm out this. Yeah, you got, you know. Shout out to that subscriber who left a comment that said I ain't been here in a minute. My bad on the delay. But this is Terrence Crawford in a nutshell. You guys want to talk about Crawford? There ain't going to be no 5-minute video, 7-minute video. You can't explain what Crawford has done in this sport in 5, 7, 30 minutes. Crawford is pound for pound the best for a reason. And this is 2 hours plus on why we believe so. Y'all work on that inside game, Crawford. Other than that, you still the best pound for pound. Even with the fight of Spence versus Porter, it didn't raise the stock. It actually brought the stock down, or it could have stayed right where it was for Spence. Porter's stock flew up. We all know that. But as far as Spence stock rising even higher, it didn't really go that far, you know? We knew Spence was going to win. We were surprised, Spence, you supposedly, I'm going to knock him out. And then you didn't do that because we knew. Even Spence probably was overlooking Porter a little bit, like he's not a bull the way people consider him. But yeah, Porter is a bull the way we consider him. That motherfucker's a fucking monster. So if it ever happened, don't be alarmed. Crawford would beat Porter. Just outbox him. He's a better he, and that's why I want the Brook fight so bad. You know, I think Crawford beats Kell Brook and Porter in a way better fashion than Spence does because of the style. You know, the style that Spence has compared to what Crawford has. Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. I don't have to throw body shots to beat the shit out you. No disrespect to Spence. If that's what works, that's what works. That's why you are the best body thrower in the fucking division or in the sport. There's no other person that goes to the body better than Spence. A hard second could be a toss-up between Canelo and Triple G. They do okay to the body. But they do not rip to the fucking body like your boy Spence. My daughter left, so. And I'm, you know. But I'm saying, you know, I can. You know, don't just be cursing around. You know what I mean? Come on, man. Cursing around the little ones. D-block. And I'm out this bitch. Let me know what y'all think in the comment section. Let me know why you consider Loma pound for pound. If you just got those three fights to go off of and an argument on why he lost, an excuse why he lost. You know, if talking about he got hit, so in the low, he got low blow. That's what everybody's saying about Loma in the first fight with Salido. Well, if that's the case, if he was that good, he shouldn't have got hit that many times. Should have outboxed him. If he had the rematch, he'd beat him this time. We ain't talking about this time. He should have did it when he was supposed to. You know? You cannot tell me an undefeated fighter with a resume of Terrence Crawford that I just explained to you is beneath someone who lost only 12 fights and don't have these type of undefeated fighters underneath his belt. Doesn't work like that. Crawford is pound for pound the best. And no other fighter really has that type of aura underneath them to make them go to the top. Don't say Canelo. I'll wash Canelo's, man, listen. I'll wash Canelo's resume. That motherfucker's resume is trash. Do not do it to yourself. Pacquiao's resume, you only got Thurman on your shit, and I don't give you that much credit because of the long layoff that Thurman has had. Don't stop it, Pacquiao. Stop. You ain't fight the active fighter that they were calling you out when you were still with Top Rank. And, you know, it was around the Spence versus, or the Crawford. It was around the Porter versus Keith Thurman era, you know? And they wanted to fight Pacquiao right then and there, you know? It's just, come on, man. Still to this day, Pacquiao is still ducking Crawford. They were both under the same banner. They both were under Top Rank. And they would keep on using Crawford's name to hype up Pacquiao. But they never, Bob wouldn't make that fight. And then he now wants to come out and say, if I would have put Pacquiao in there with Crawford, he would have won. Well, isn't that what you do, Bob? You keep everything in-house, so why wouldn't you do that? Why can't you make your boy Loma go up to 147? It's too big. You can't go to 147. Uh-huh. But people can jump up two weight classes to fight him. Ain't nobody jumping up two weight classes to fight Crawford. So the ball's in Crawford's court. He has to decide himself. Is he going to listen to that bullshit, that rhetoric out there with Bob Arum selling him? Or is he going to go and be a boss like everybody else is showing him how to be? Not just us say it. Is he going to go out there and show he's the best fighter on the planet? And say it, too. Say it. D-Block, man. It's just, I've seen a lot of videos up lately, man. It was getting a little too, it was turning to the level a little too much. You know, let's bounce this table back out. And when you talk about your boy Crawford, you better realize who the fuck you talking about. Crawford is pound for pound the best fighter in the sport. It's not. Well, we can't say that anymore, huh? I was going to say it's not close, but hey, it's getting there. Because your man Spence is building that resume, you know? He's building that resume, man. And with Porter underneath that resume, man. Porter underneath that belt. Hey, Crawford. Porter underneath Spence's belt is equivalent to three of your undefeated fighters. Jose Benavidez, Jeff Horn, and Ndongo. No, not Ndongo, because Ndongo was undefeated. But Porter was a world champion, too. It's just that Porter is elite status. And Crawford, you don't have elite status underneath you yet. Even though you have shown that you are elite status. Anyway, man, leave it in the comment section. Who actually thinks Porter would, like, don't say that out of hate. I just told you why Crawford's the best, and you guys can't, that's the truth, you know? So, when you guys say that Porter would destroy Crawford, a lot of times I could tell if it's coming from hate, or if you know what the fuck you talking about. You know what I mean? You actually think, since you ain't good to the body, Crawford, Porter loves going to the body. Loves it. We gonna see, you know? But everybody that knows boxing should know Crawford's jab and Crawford's reach should keep Porter at bay. And if he does come in close, you tie him up and then back out to your jabs. So let me know what y'all think. I want to know Crawford versus Porter, Crawford versus Spence. How does each opponent win? Why do you have another opponent pound for pound the best? Do you believe Crawford is pound for pound the best? He is the best. But do you think he deserves it if he's not going to stand up for why we consider him the best? That moping picture with Bob Arum talking and Crawford just sitting there just looking down, dumbfounded, pissed off. It looks like he feels like I'm not recognized as the best. Ain't I beating everybody you guys put in front of me? You know what I mean? But the difference is true bosses, they go and decide who they want to have put in front of them. Not for somebody else to tell them who they're going to fight next. You know what I mean? Crawford, we waiting for you, man. Hurry up, man. Stop taking so fucking long. And don't re-sign that contract. You re-sign that contract, bro. It doesn't really take away from you being the best. And your age is getting up there. You getting up there in age, bro. Yeah, man. I didn't know you were into your 30s, you know? I think Spence is still in his 20s. It makes a difference, man. It makes a difference. Statistically, I looked it up. Statistically, a person's athletic ability greatness dies at 34. Not even 35. It's funny because Superman is actually 35 years old and he can't age anymore. But it's 34. Crawford, I believe you're 33, my boy. So the best we're going to see is right now. We got one more year of it. So we're going to see, man. D-Block, and I'm out this